praise the Lord to all the saints and people of God. We're glad to be here this morning to bring God's word unto you. Thank the Lord for Apostolic Church of Jesus for having us to come on the broadcast. This is my first time, but we're leaning on Jesus to help us this morning to give you what the Lord, what we feel the Lord has given unto us. We're going to start off with prayer, asking God to take over. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you for your blessings, asking now that would come into our homes, into our lives, into our ears, and our eyes, and Lord God, intervene. Let the anointing be upon each and every one of us. Bless your messenger to speak thy word in Jesus' name. Amen. Quickly turn with me to Jeremiah in the Old Testament, the 9th chapter, the 23rd and the 24th verse. It says, thus saith the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man glory in his might. Let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him that glorieth glory in this. Listen to God now, that he understandeth and knoweth me, that I am the Lord, which exercise loving kindness, judgment, and righteousness in the earth. For in these things I delight, saith the Lord. God wants man to glory in knowing who he is, to glory in him. So many times, and even on today when we're depressed and we're stressed out, and things are heavy on our hearts and minds, it seems like everything is going wrong, we're glorying in ourselves. We're giving the people on the front line the glory, the doctors and the police, and all that's good. Don't get me wrong. Give credit to whom credit is due, and service to whom service is due. But we forgot the main thing, and that's God himself. Now, they're in certain areas, and they're doing their job. I could say today, God has done his job. The scriptures say, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He did his work. And when he finished his work on the sixth day, he looked at it and saw that it was good. Also, in Genesis, he said, let us make man in our own image. God made man in his image and breathed into his nostril, and he became what? A living soul. Now this is what God did. He created the heavens, the earth, the sun, the moon, the stars, the universe. Everything that you can see, everything that you can touch, God created it. And even when man fell in sin by disobeying God, all disobedience is sin. When it goes against God's command, of God's word, or what God has instructed us to do, it's sin. And God has let us to know that he created all. Let me go to Malachi 1 and 6. This is what it says. A son honoreth his father, and a servant his master. If then I be a father, where is my honor? And if I be a master, where is my fear? Saith the Lord of hosts unto you, O priest or preacher that despise my name, and ye say, wherein have we despised thy name? When you rejected the name Jesus, the God-given name that saves us, the name that God gave to save man. The scripture says he has given us a name which is above every name. God has given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, I believe that's Philippians, every knee should bow, every tongue should confess. Huh? And that neither in Acts 4 and 12 is there salvation in any other. There is no other name under heaven given among men, whereby we must be saved. We need to know God's name. The subject I want to give to you today is this: to God be the glory. Don't change your glory. What has happened to humanity, we have changed our glory. We want the credit. We want the praise. We want people to lift us up. Some are preaching so people can praise them. Some are doing this and that and the other so they can receive recognition. So men can glorify them. You can say, I did this and I did that. But who put the sun up there? Who put the moon out there? Each thing has a glory of its own. But now the scripture says in Hebrews 3:3-4, God made it all. Is that right? God made it all. And in Colossians, it brings out that God, I think it's the first chapter of Colossians, or the second chapter, it brings out that the world was created by Jesus. All things consist by him. Now, I know you're looking at the Old Testament and said, God kept talking about himself. So why in the New Testament is it referring to Jesus? Because Jesus is the Almighty God. And the world don't know it yet. A lot of people don't believe. But he is the everlasting Father. He is the Almighty God, the Prince of Peace. Excuse me. In Isaiah, the 43rd chapter, and the 7th verse says this: even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. It's time to give God his glory. We take time out to praise one another. We take time out to give things that we see and touch glory. What about God's glory? What about giving God the praise? What about glorifying him? We give too much credit to the flesh and not enough to the Spirit of God. God is in control and he's working every day. He wakes you up. He heals your body. He gives you strength. He gives you, gave you life. If God takes what he gave to man back from him, he could be nothing but clay, nothing but dust. It's in God that we live and we move and we have our being. Now look at 42:8 in Isaiah. I am the Lord, that is my name. Somebody needs to stop fighting the name of the Lord. Because you're going to find out it's a strong title. And it's hard to kick against God's name. But we don't reverence that name because we don't know his name. Jesus said, I come in my Father's name. Is that right? And my glory, he says here in the 8th verse, will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Because man does not know who God is. He's praising everything but God himself. It's time to give God the glory. Find out who God is. Find out who your Father is. It's a shame when a child doesn't know who their parents are. You don't know who your daddy is, who your mother is, who's bringing in the income, who's dressing you every day, and who's feeding you every day. God deserves the honor, the glory, and the praise. He's the one that's keeping us alive. Through this virus, God's keeping us. God's healing us. Every day, God's seeing about you and caring about you. Where is his glory? It's time for the church to give God all the glory. When they threaten us and said, don't preach and teach in his name, that didn't stop Peter and John. They continued and went back rejoicing and giving glory to God himself. And then they called him back and said, did not we threaten you and tell you not to preach or teach in this man's name? Behold, you fill Jerusalem with your doctrine, intending to bring his blood upon us. Peter, let them know we ought to obey God rather than men. It's time that if you know who God is, if you know the truth, give him the glory he's due. He's you all the praise and all the glory because of who he is. Praise him for who he is. He's not a man. He's God. Men are limited. We have limitations. We can't be everywhere at the same time, but God can. We can make promises, and we put our word out there. Some of it comes to pass, and some of it we can't fulfill. But God can. There is no limitations on the Lord God Almighty. He is the Almighty God, and he deserves our praise. Nobody should have to force us to recognize him and to reverence his name. If you know his name, give glory to it. If you know who he is, preach about it. Teach about it. Talk about it. Talk to your children. Talk about it around the dinner table. Tell your family who God is. Tell your co-workers and your neighbors who he is. If you know who he is, this ain't the time to stop. This is the time to spread the good news. Tell them how he died. Tell them why he died. Tell them why he had to come. He had to root up the problem, sin. Somebody said, well, I quit smoking, I quit drinking, but you still got sin in your life. You were born in it, wrapped and shaped in iniquity. You came out the womb a sinner. Your mother had no choice. She had you, and that was good, but you're still a sinner. Somebody said, I do work in the church. I go to church every Sunday. That's good, but you're not saved yet. You need salvation. God has a plan, a salvation plan for man. God wants to save man, and he's doing it through his blood. The only way you can get the blood is through the name Jesus. That's what makes the baptism so important. That's what makes doing it God's way so important. Our ways are not God's way. Our thoughts are not God's thoughts. When everybody got a plan, when everybody got a way, you find out nobody's doing it God's way. Nobody believes God's word. We read books every day. We go to school. We learn and we learn. We've got a library set up. I guarantee you the least book they read is the Bible. They don't want to accept God's word. God's word is right. Not one jot or one tittle is going to come from it. It's going to go out and accomplish its mission. If you know the word of God, you would know right now everything that's happening is according to the scriptures. We come to you today with the truth of the scriptures. It don't profit me to tell you what I think and my opinion and my views on things. I need to tell you what thus says the Lord. The only way I'm able to do that, I've got to have his spirit dwelling in me. I've got to know who my Father is. You've got to get the identity right. Sin separated us from our Father, from God himself. You cannot dwell in the midst of God with sin all in your life. So you need to find out what sin is all about so you can get rid of it. If you want to get rid of the virus that's going around, you've got to find the cure. I'm here to tell you today that Jesus is the cure. He's got the remedy. He's got the vaccine. He knows exactly what to do to heal the land. He said that my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray. Seek my face and turn. Notice he put that in there. Turn from their what? Wicked ways. Then shall you hear from heaven. Then I'll heal your land. If we put Jesus as the first and the last. You can't make him last. You can't say, well, I'm going to do all of this, then I'm going to call on Jesus. Or people say, pray for me. God bless America. In God we trust. Who is your God? Who is your Father? If you don't know his name, you don't know. How can you say you know God and you don't even know your Father's name? His name is Jesus. That's the name that saves you. Why? Because the blood is in it. And you need the blood. That's why it's so important that you seek after it. He said in John 5:39, search the scriptures. In them you think you have life. They are they that testify who? Of me. Now this is Jesus talking. It includes the Old Testament and the New Testament. In the the Old Testament the prophets wrote and prophesied. They were preaching and prophesying about Jesus. They just didn't know his name, the saving name. The name is Jesus. You can call the name Jesus and he'll heal your body. He'll give you peace in your mind. When the ship was rocking and they woke Jesus up and said, Lord, don't you care? He just stood up and looked around and said, peace, be still. How could he do it? He's God. Yes, he was manifest in the flesh. The word was made flesh. And it's without controversy, y'all. Great is the mystery of godliness. But what you've got to do, first of all, is repent. Believe the word. Believe it. Hear it. Hear it from a preacher of God that God has called and sent. Once you hear it, obey it. Don't just sit there and just clap your hands. Don't just sit there and tell the choir, go ahead and sing. Get up and go down in Jesus' name. Let the word convict you. Let it prick your heart that you're ready to obey God. It's time to give God the glory. Don't change your glory. In the book of Romans, the first chapter, that came to my mind. The first chapter, look what he says. He said, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness. And the 21st verse says, because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God. Neither were thankful, but became vain, what in their imaginations. And their foolish heart was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. This is what they did wrong. They changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image. That's what the world is doing today. That's what the people that should know God are doing. We're changing God's glory into an image. God is a spirit. And they that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. And into an image made like to corruptible man. What is it, man wants something he can see? That's how they got in trouble wanting the king. Somebody they can see and look upon. Instead of having faith and trusting and letting God be their king. They wanted a king like the other nations. God is our king. God is God. Let's worship him as God. Don't take God for granted. Don't take his kindness for granted. When you come into his house, into his courts, come in with praise. Give him thanks. Get happy. Get happy while you're cooking your food. Get happy in your home. Meditate upon it. Think of his goodness. God brought you through. God brought you out of it. God calmed the storm. God gave you life. You woke up this morning. Not by an alarm clock. It was God that let the clock go off. It was God that's giving you strength. Your wisdom come from God. Stop glorying in yourself. We've got to give God the praise. It's time for us, church, to give God praise. Worship him in the beauty of holiness. Taste and see that the Lord, he's good. Man or woman, boy or girl, it doesn't matter who you are. To God be the glory for the things he has done. He will do. He's doing right now, and he's going to do just for you now. God is keeping us. He's keeping our minds. He's giving us the strength we need to fight with, to stand still. The Bible says, stand still and know that I am God. Not that I'm a man. He's God. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word was made flesh and dwelled among us. That which we've seen and heard, we're going to declare it to you. Somebody got to stand up and tell them who God is. Don't stop now. The prophets kept on telling it. Isaiah told it. Malachi told it. Zacharias told it. We've got to tell it in 2020. Jesus is the Almighty God. It's the God that you're serving that can hinder you. If you're not serving the true and living God, you're wavering, you're shaking, you don't know which way to go. But when you serve the Almighty God, they got no fault. They talked about the Philistine God. He can't stand. Because you made it and you got to carry him. He don't have no legs, no arms. How does he get around? Man has to carry him. But when you serve the Almighty God, who is a spirit, you learn how to walk with him, talk with him, share your thoughts. Even before you think it, he knows your thoughts. He knows what you need before you come ask him. When you get down on your knees, he knows what you're going to say. When you don't know what to say, God already knows and understands. What a mighty God we serve. God wants the glory. It's time for man to give God glory and praise. Don't you think? Don't you think it's time that we recognize who our Father is, who our Savior is, who saved us from sin? That's the disease that's killing us, sin. You can die a good person and still die in sin. We over here at Apostolic Church of Jesus, 1964 Road, Plymouth Road, Detroit, Michigan. We're calling for you to come. If you've heard the word and it pricked your heart, it got your attention. That's God trying to tell you something. He's trying to tell you, give him glory. And if you glorify him, he don't mean just clap your hands and sing a song. He wants you to do more than that. He wants you to obey him. Obey his law. Come on, let's give in to God and surrender all that we have. He said, love, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Thou shalt worship the Lord with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. Give it all to him. You can't go wrong. God will bless your house, your children, your life, your going in and your coming out. God will teach you his laws and put them in your heart. That's what we need. He'll heal you of a disease called sin. He's the cure today. I dare you to take time out these 4 months that we've been out in prison. Give us a call, area code 313-272-0702. We're ready to take you down in God's name, Jesus. We're ready. Yes, we're Jesus only. From my head to my toe, I'm going to preach Jesus. I'm going to talk about Jesus. I'm excited about Jesus. He's my everything, my all in all. I don't need nobody to tell me, praise the Lord, John. Clap your hands. It's good when they say it, but the truth is, I got him down on the inside. I can praise him right now. Can you praise him right now where you're at? You're in your living room. You're in the kitchen. Can you dance for him now? Can you shout hallelujah to the truth right now? If you don't know it's the truth, come on by. Give us a call. We'll take the scriptures and prove it to you. According to the scriptures, that is all done in Jesus' name. He is the Almighty God. Give him the glory. Don't change your glory in church. Give God all of it. Thank you very much for allowing us to come to you. Amen.
But when Adam bit of the tree, heaven doors closed, and we had no more access to God.